You ready to fight? Ready.
Do All it. Right, here we go. Just misses there with the left. Head kick attempt, it's blocked. Now lands a kick to the body. Oh, and he lands another combination here, really starting to get into a striking game.
I mean, it's stringing them together so effectively. Never throwing the same attack more than once. What a job to recognize all the openings in his opponent's defenses. Oh, big elbow.
Both fighters throwing heat now. Takedown.
Yes, smart adjustment. Yep.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Under 3 minutes to go in round one.
Body kick lands. Liver kick.
Another nice combination, just absolutely picking him apart on the feet. I'd probably be tapping due to strikes. Quick level chain. Oh!
Stands on his back. What a takedown.
How's that feel to be on the
ground? I mean, honestly,
I knew that was coming. Straight punch is good. All right, so now we start to see some bruising appearing on the torso and all of that courtesy of the body work of his opponent.
Just the wherewithal to go to the body and the discipline to stay with that approach. I mean, it's just tremendous. You see a fighter with a high fight IQ following a game plan, and it's working.
Quick entry to get on a single.
That was a great single.
Cormier Express. Big shots being landed on both sides here. Yeah, left hook found its target. All right, looks as though that strike maybe opened up a cut around the eye.
Yeah, it looks like that strike opened up a cut, John, but there's nothing to worry about now. But he's got to start to protect. Oh, he landed. He hurt it. Beautiful. Neon belly. Postures up. Neon belly. He's raining down ground and pound. He has to move. Oh, the fight is going to get stopped.
Now he's masterful from here.
Oh, he went to a single, switched to a high crotch. He takes it for a ride. What a high impact takedown it was.
Second round, straight ahead. All right, so the round is over, but not before damage was done. Cut on the cheek, sustained in that round. Cut man in there quickly as usual to try to seal it up.
Keep doing what you're doing. Push the pace.
All right, so a big knockdown for him, courtesy of that punch in that round. DC, here's your replay.
Big moment in the previous round. They were both fighting very well, but when he landed this punch right here that sits his opponent down, it showed that the power is not equal, and if he can land, he does have the ability to damage him.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two. All right, next round is now underway. Hopefully the action continues at a high level. Pretty good first 5 minutes.
Pretty good first 5 minutes. Both of them can really pick it up. Let's see who decides they're going to lead the dance as we go forward.
Ooh, and he caught the kick. Establishing the jab. Oh, strong hook to the head there by Seaver. Well, you can just see he is oozing with confidence, and not overconfidence, but a big knockdown in round one, likely the source of that confidence.
Once everything is going great, you tend to feel like he can walk through a wall. He doesn't need to walk through a wall. He needs to continue to find the right avenue to land those shots.
Starting to do here's some really significant quick entry here. Seaver gets back up. Just over 3 minutes to go. Quick level change.
Rotates the line. What a massive takedown. Huge body kick land.
Now Owen, a quick inch.
What a huge takedown.
I mean, do I survive that or
not? Absolutely not. You don't survive this. It's over. It's over, John. Another big takedown.
Seaver gets back up. Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket. All right, so now blood is a factor. You see that he has been opened up in that eye area.
Yeah, he's got hit in the eye, and now there's a cut. But it's nothing to worry about too much now. But he's got to be very careful with it as we go forward.
Useful hook there. Seaver going for the takedown here. Nothing doing there. Nice job by him defensively there. Heavy leather landed on both sides in that exchange. Under a minute to go here in our second round. Oh, man, I'm starting to feel bad for the canvas as he lands another takedown there.
He landed another takedown, and he's doing it over and over again. What I am a massive fan of is his cardio, the ability to be able to keep this pace over and over as he hits these takedown attempts.
Nicely done. Seaver gets back up again. Takedown attempt late, and it's good. All right, that's the end of round number two. All right, there's the horn indicating the end of the round. So potentially a big factor here, ladies and gentlemen. The cut on the cheek sustained in that round. Certainly better to be below than above the eye, but the cut man's got to get in there and close that thing up. All right, so there's the horn at the end of the round. Multiple takedowns landed for him over the previous 5 minutes.
And you know what, John? Even more importantly, look at the opponent now. He's afraid to pull the trigger because he's been taken down so many times. Getting taken down is one thing. But getting it, having it happen to you continuously.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. All right, so back-to-back entertaining rounds. We'll see how it goes. And there is a lands, and maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick.
Seaver's head kick attempt, that one is blocked. Well, his opponent seemed to be stunned to a significant extent, but was able to recover, and it's almost like he let him off the hook.
Kind of let him off the hook. He needed to really put his foot on the gas to try to find that finish.
Seaver's eye is closing up. Changes levels now. Oh! Changed. Oh!
Big takedown. What a technique. What a takedown. Great high impact skill.
You could feel the canvas reverberating here at the rock.
I mean, right there. Boom, 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 boom. It's like me running anywhere, John.
Oh, he gets tagged again. Nice combination. So, new round, same narrative as he takes him down again.
He does a fantastic job finding the takedown attempt, not wasting the energy. A lot of times people lose. The takedown's not easy. Don't waste the energy. This guy got it done very easily.
Oh, he's got the Kimura locked in. Oh, somehow, some way he got out.
These guys are back and forth, but the submission defense wins this transition. Back and forth we go.
Well, now that cut in the eye area, Daniel, becoming a major storyline. He's got to be careful.
He's got to be very careful and address it right now before it gets to the point that there's nothing you can do about it.
Late in the fight now, he needs a finish or he's going to lose this fight tonight. We'll see if he goes. Quick entry to get
Man,
in on a
that
single.
That was a great single.
Oh!
My God, he switched back out to a high cross, rotated, and then took a full ride. That was a big takedown.
Well, he is really seeing things well offensively here tonight, and he's caused a lot of swelling there on his opponent.
You got to address this now, because it's only going to get worse. Your opponent is not going to let you off the hook. You've got to move. You've got to change something to try to deter him from going to that spot.
Somebody's going to have to press here. This fight seems to be on the table.
All right, half guard now. Not a fighter you want in half guard against you. For the bottom fighter, what does he need to do?
He needs to secure his underhook. He's got to be fighting for underhook. One of the most key things you can do as a bottom fighter stuck in half guard is try to frame. You frame and push your opponent away from you. By pushing him away from you, he will then want to come back into you.
Right.
It's like when I push you back, you want to go forward. So as he comes forward, hand goes off the face, let it slip into an underhook, build up. He needs to get on the bicycle, John. He needs to get into space so that he doesn't get finished.
Official decision now in. The Buff has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision.
This fight is considered a majority draw.
All right, so the fight goes to the judges' scorecards, and it is scored a majority draw. Both fighters had their moments. It was an exciting fight, and no red stripe on the Wikipedia page for either fighter. That's pretty good news.
Yeah, you know, neither guy gets a loss, and both guys had good...